Dr. Faud Halim, you know, the CPIM, which ran this state for years, for decades, was the one party that was largely immune to this family politics, and perhaps still is, out of all the political parties. Do you think that's an advantage or a disadvantage? As the CPIM slips in Bengal, becomes irrelevant in large parts of the country, why is it that, you know, why is it that the CPIM is unable to combat both these large forces that now exist in Indian politics, the BJP and to some extent the Congress? You genuinely were a party that broke away from family politics, and yet it's not worked for you.
Well, I'll start off with a little what you call story. You know, when Indira Gandhi as Prime Minister of India visited America, and she was greeted by George Bush with the term as the first, as representative of the democratic dynasty. He used the word democratic dynasty. Now, it's very, very poignant, because he himself became the father of the democratic dynasty in US of A. So, you know, democratic dynasties, you know, they span the whole spectrum. And if you talk about wives replacing husbands, you've got Hillary Clinton trying to replace Bill Clinton in America. So it's an entire, what you call, conundrum of families that are impacting politics. As far as the left is concerned, you know, I'm a third generation, what you call, entrant into politics. My grandfather was a councillor under Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose when he was mayor of Calcutta Corporation. My father and then me. But as far as the left ideology goes, it was very clear that I would not contest as long as my father was in office. That was very clear within us, within the family. And the second thing was that I never contested in any constituency that my father stood for. So every time I stood in a different constituency away from where he contested from. So those are the legacies that the left brings to the understanding of political dynasties, if you put it in that way.
So you see that as a badge of pride, then why is it that the left is unable to sort of also bring through new talents? Why have you been unable to sort of bring in new talents whom the people will connect with?
I think so. That's a contradiction, because the left has not been encouraging political dynasties. You've always got left being represented by fresher, what you call, people. Newer people get opportunities more in the left, and I think so. That's one of the singular landmarks of the left movement in India.
But maybe as Mr. Chaudhary says, that the people of this country feel safer with political dynasties. Yeah, in Malda today, they perhaps feel that Ghani Khan Chaudhary's family members will perhaps do more for Malda than people from the left or from who are outside the system.
You see, in a feudal society, this very idea of a feudal legacy, you know, if you have a Shraddh, you have the son introducing himself after his father has passed away. But you look at the entire spectrum of our cultural activities, which comes from feudal idea, this will import itself into the political system also. And it will be valued by people who are still in the feudal mode of thought. So until we don't break through that, you're not going to impact the political system effectively. The forces today in India don't want to break the feudal setup, whether it be at the rural level, whether it be at the understanding of how caste plays itself out in the general political system of ours. And it's not going to impact itself in our, what you call, political system also. The left is against it, which is why me as a part of the political dynasty is very, very different from other political parties, as I mentioned earlier.